In past videos, I'm sure you've noticed that I complain about a lot of guys. It warrants those complaints in the sense that those guys really did suck. But there's always that flip side, right? The other story where I suck too. There are things about me that aren't great. Like, we all knew that. We all have our own flaws, but sometimes it's very hard to see that when you're so concentrated on what someone else has done to you. After the turn of events in the last week, and actually in the last 24 hours, I've decided there are 5 major reasons for why you should not go on a date with me. Number one is I don't trust my gut instincts. So this happened to me quite recently. I've been going on dates with this guy that I mentioned on my ghosting live stream from earlier this week. I mentioned that I was waiting for his text and we were on date number 4. The thing is, I knew in my gut from date number 2 that this guy and I were not gonna work out. I kind of knew what he wanted and it wasn't what I wanted. He wanted something that I knew I wasn't ready for, but I still went along with the date, the subsequent dates. The reason why I keep on looking to the side of the camera is because I'm reading off of my notes that I put in my phone. So if anyone steals my phone, you have access to my personal diary, more or less. I knew what his intentions were. Hey, what did I continue doing? I just continued going on dates as if I didn't know and I was just blatantly ignoring it. It wasn't until I asked him yesterday explicitly, like, what are you looking for? Where I realized I was in the wrong. My friends have repeatedly told me, like, Sam, you should have cut this off 2 dates ago. You should have cut this off a long time ago. When I first was telling my friends about this guy, they knew that we weren't gonna work out and I knew it wasn't gonna work out, but I didn't trust my gut. And I continued going on these dates. Moving forward, I know if my gut says something, I really should listen to it and spare everyone involved. Number 2, I do what I want. So when I say I do what I want, I mean I will ask my friends for advice. And what do? I just do exactly the opposite and what I want. So it's like, why did I even bother asking? And I'm sure they feel that way too. And it must be so frustrating being my friend, just because I will go to someone for advice, but then I won't follow their advice. So it's like, why did you ask in the first place? And I totally get that. It's very frustrating. The attitude of doing what you want is great, in the sense that you should really do what you want and you shouldn't do what other people are telling you to do. And you should really, like, for example, like, career-wise, do what you want versus like what your parents tell you or what someone else tells you. But that being said, if someone gives you advice and you blatantly ignore it, knowing that they're right, that's when you're in the wrong. You're hurting someone else by doing what you want. That's when you're in the wrong. I really need to apologize to my friends for not listening to them, even though they want the best for me. My I do what I want attitude is hurting a lot of people around me. And I'm really sorry for that. So that leads to number 3, I have trouble listening. So I have difficulty listening to someone, both in the sense that, clearly from number 2, that I just don't listen to people's advice, but also I tune out of conversations a lot. It's not great. It's really not great. I'm genuinely working on this. Even in the work setting, it's really hard for me to concentrate. A lot of times I just don't remember what someone has said. This could make people feel not heard, of course, and feel very frustrated because they have to repeatedly say something. For whatever reason, I just can't. I just have really bad listening skills and I know I need to be an active listener. Past dates have told me I don't listen, in the sense that, like, I literally do not hear what they're saying. When you're not listening to someone, this could make people feel not heard, of course, but also makes them think that you're disinterested in them. So I'm sure many dates may have thought, I'm just not interested in them just because I don't remember the little details about them, or I just don't remember anything they said. I never want someone to feel that way because I know how it feels to not be heard and not to be listened to. I've experienced that a lot. I'm sure you have too. This is something I'm definitely working on, and I'm well aware I have trouble listening to people. Number 4, I can give mixed signals. I can be hot and cold, and while I hate that behavior in other people, I know I'm totally guilty of it. I don't think anyone ever intends on being misleading, but it doesn't make it right. In my situation, and I'm sure in most situations, the mixed signals have nothing to do with the other person, but it definitely has an effect on the other person because they're like, what is going on? Like, the other person just feels like, what did they do wrong? You know, I definitely have felt that before with other dates where I just didn't know where I stood because they were playing hot and cold. And it's very frustrating on the other end, but I do that too. Awful. I'm garbage. I'm still trying to figure myself out. I have my own issues. Everyone has their own issues. They have their own things going on in their lives. But you shouldn't bring it to the table, and you shouldn't have other people that are not involved in your issues directly affected. Like, if you watched the video where I sent a survey to all my past Cornell dates, even one guy mentioned that I shouldn't have gone on a date with him if I was tired. I remember that date clearly, and I know what I was going through during that date. It was just my internal turmoils. He was right, I should have canceled. The fifth reason you shouldn't go on a date with me, work is a priority. So the thing is, this isn't a bad thing ever, and should always have something else going on in your life. But I take it to the extreme. There are only a couple slots in a week where I will go on dates with someone or just socialize. Those slots are usually on the weekends and for like 2 to 3 hours. Like, only, I think on Saturday I have a 2 to 3 hour slot, and Sunday I make a 2 to 3 hour slot to socialize. And socializing includes friends and dates. Then I'll prioritize my friends over dates. As a result, that leaves not a lot of time to be hanging out with someone, even if you're interested in them, just because for me, my life revolves around work. No one wants to feel like an appointment. Honestly, it may come across that way. I will not be willing to alter my schedule for someone else. And that's something I need to work on. My therapist actually helped me like create like a pie chart of like where, what, how my life is distributed in terms of like work stuff, personal, you know, in this pie chart. He figured out that in this pie chart, work is 50% of my life. And then there were other segments, of course, but then personal and like dating, that kind of socializing was 5%. 5%, that's not a lot. If I want something serious or a relationship, I really need to start prioritizing people in general more. That isn't to say that I shouldn't prioritize work. Like, I think work should still be a priority. I just shouldn't make people feel like they're an appointment. That's how I come across. I just need to start prioritizing people more. So these are the top 5 reasons for why someone shouldn't date me. These are things I'm working on, and I know if I genuinely put the work in, my dating experience would probably be better. That being said, what are the reasons why people shouldn't date you? Sure, there are reasons, because no one's perfect. We all have our flaws, and I know I'm not alone in this. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and to all the guys that want to date me, these are 5 great reasons why you don't want to. You can't say you haven't been warned. Anyways, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.